Discovery, go at throttle up.
Hello, EG47 Recon here again. Thank you for watching another video. As you can see, I have a ton of stuff in front of me. It was my kid's spring break, so we took a little road trip from California through Nevada, stayed Las Vegas, and on the way to Zion National Park in Utah. But along the way, I stopped for a few things, local LCS in the area, especially in Vegas, and a couple of banks along the way. And one of the biggest things I went through is the world famous gold and silver pawn shop in Las Vegas. As you know, the Pawn Stars on History Channel, this is where they film the Pawn Stars episodes and series with Rick, Chumley, and Big Hans. So I was able to pass by through that location. Got in, not a lot of people due to COVID, but had a perfect opportunity. So I bought two items in there just to make sure that I got something. They have a wide selection of coins and other memorabilia inside the store. But of course, I was there for coins. And this one I will reveal on a video. I'm not going to show you what's inside, but I'm going to reveal it in a video coming soon, probably next week. But this one, my son loves rocks and fossils, so I found this one. It's a trilobite fossil that they had for about 25 bucks, which is a little more on the expensive side, but it's okay. But it's a trilobite fossil. It has a little crack right there, but there's a couple of them. The other one looks a little uglier. This has more detail, so I got this one for my son. The other things I went through the bank. This is in St. George, Utah, along the way to Zion. This is $100 worth of singles. And this was from the bank in Las Vegas near my hotel. So this is also $100, but it has the Federal Reserve notes strap on it. So this is kind of interesting what to see what this is. So those will be in a separate video that I'm going to do. I went to another pawn shop in Vegas and I found three of these SMS sets. This is a 66 and a 67, two 67s. I might just sell them off or give them to a relative that is also a coin collector. The other thing that I bought at that pawn shop was a South Korean season canis, 110 ounce gold. Add to my collection, my stack basically. And then I went to another local LCS and got five of these brilliant uncirculated Benjamin Franklins. It's from 1959, 60, 61, 62, and 63. So I was able to find them in succession. Also found a couple of these at the Las Vegas coin show. It's actually a Philippine 1 peso post-war, so it has the victory marking on the back. It's post-war, so Japanese were defeated in the Philippines and the Philippines was liberated. So I got these from the Las Vegas coin show. Another item I got on the Las Vegas coin show was this MS65 1971 silver $1. It was kind of been in the bargain bin, so I just said, yeah, let's go get it. Looks nice enough, and then I might be able to use it in one of the giveaways down the road. And also in the Las Vegas coin show, I got 110 ounce gold eagle. I believe it's 2004, sorry. So that's one of those pickups. And I also, each time I went to the bank, I also got a box of quarters in Las Vegas and a box of pennies in Las Vegas. Although the funny thing about the Las Vegas pennies, they're still marked Los Angeles. So I guess Brinks goes all the way up to Las Vegas. But on St. George, Utah, I was able to grab a bunch of nickels, a box of nickels, which is in a, I believe, a Loomis style box. So I'll put that in a separate video coming up. But overall, this is a nice collection on the road trip. So I was able to make time and, say, pass by a certain coin store or the bank along the way. So family had fun. But overall, I'm happy for future content to the channel. And this, like I said, will reveal in a coming video, probably next week. That's all I have for today. Thank you for watching and have a good day.